works in this way. Like, it's not like in Smash where it's really malleable and you can just kind of mess around with anything that you want. It either works in Street Fighter or it doesn't.
Yeah, but we can talk more about Street Fighter later. Right now we have PL versus 9S, another part of the Plant Gang.
I'm not surprised. Plant Gang
coming out tonight.
Yeah,
I like it.
And speaking of Bayo, hey, we got a Bayo. I'm actually kind of waiting to see what this Bayonetta does. Oh my god. Good job. Spitchewy. You know, I'm seeing a lot of people use it in the neutral as well as edge guarding. It seems like something, if you learn how to control it, you can really mess with people's day. Look at that.
Yeah, okay, so it has a hitbox as it falls. So even if you hit Piranha Plant out of like blowing air at it, it still has an active hitbox. So that's good to know.
Yeah. Even after it hits the ground.
Okay, charging up the poison. So I love the addition of that poison cloud, just being able to charge it up and then hold on to it, kind of like she needles.
Yeah. And then it stays there.
It stays there, and then it obscures vision, so you can actually like use it as a smoke screen.
Yeah.
Like, what is he doing?
Ooh.
Kinda you gotta like wait for a second.
Kind of like a Toon Link and his bombs. I like that little effect.
Kind of, but I want to see it used like in a ledge trapping situation.
Oh, you better believe that's gonna happen. I can already see that.
Okay, great ABK into Witch Twist. It's gonna get PL back on stage and put a little bit of damage on a 9S.
Oh, sliding underneath the two. Okay.
Oh, taking him for a ride, but that up air has no kill power now, but that back air does.
How heavy is Piranha Plant?
I'm not sure.
And I'm
that's
also
something I gotta look up still.
I'm also wondering if he has a crawl, because that would be really nice against Bayonetta's neutral beat.
I feel like just the way he moves, the bullet arts isn't going to be a threat to him.
That's
because by the time he is within like a distance where the bullet arts could hit him, he could just, you know, use his neutral B and throw the spike wall.
Or charge up and miss. He has a lot of options. Okay. Just keep it up.
Look at that. He can even jump up.
That's pretty nice. That was pretty nice. Like, he seems to have a pretty good connection on like how neutral B works already. Good rapid jab.
You definitely tell 9S has spent a little bit of time in the lab figuring out how this character works. A good use of these spike balls.
My god, that hitbox really lasts. Just like you said, hey, it's starting to put in a little bit of work.
Yeah, and I like the position that he placed the poison cloud, because even when PL was hanging on the ledge, he was taking damage.
It covered a lot of options.
Yeah, it covered a lot of options, but it also says, you can stay on that ledge, you're just going to be taking damage regardless. Wow, there's your answer to the bullet arts. Forget the waddle or a crouch.
Very nice stuff. Okay. Yeah, this Bayonetta is... Okay. If Bayonetta cannot take any damage besides that, we're looking at a good game here.
That recovery is so silly.
Yeah.
I love it.
Yeah, I've seen people die by it. It's pretty horrifying. Oh no, that was overextending for sure.
It was, but I mean, when you have an opponent at 120%+, you're really just trying to get rid of that stock, and you can get baited or even like tunnel vision on getting that kill. And I think that's what we're starting to see PL do.
Yeah.
We're seeing a lot of smash attacks come out.
Oh, that was quick.
I want to see PL because that move is actually very telegraphed. Which time that?
Yeah.
Because he the entire time his neck is extended, he's still able to be punished.
Yeah, it's true. I'm thinking he can start doing the witch time.
Oh, just down air. Just down air that. That was a re-grab. Just stand at the ledge and down air.
Yeah, gotta have that confidence. Okay, charging up that poison. I wonder what would happen if Bayonetta just did the witch time on the twoies. Like,
it has to be within a... Or at least... I'm not sure anymore. But if you were within a certain distance before... of your projectile, you would still activate the witch time.
This guy is cheeky with his
Okay, so you can witch time the poison cloud.
Very nice.
It'll still work.
Very nice.
Nice.
Oh, okay. We come back to a death screen. Why not?
You still know who, what? Oh, that's the wind screen. That's so cool.
Oh, Mario got booted out of there. Nice. Very nice.
That's hilarious. Mario gets bodied in Piranha Plant. Like, what if Piranha Plant was actually playing like a Mario in tournament?
Oh, yeah.
Like, we had like some crazy matchup like Salem versus Ally, and then Ally brought out Mario, and then Salem like counterpicks with Piranha Plant, and then that's the win screen.
And he was like, oh, yo, I wonder if like if Ally were to pick, if the Mario picks a certain color, and if Piranha Plant beats him, does he still stay as the original plumber, or does it bring his skin into
it? I would hope it brings in the skin.
That would be
cool. And I would hope that if you play Luigi, it interchanges with Luigi.
That would be nice.
That'd be funny.
That would be nice.
Okay, so I was actually a little surprised that PL's picked Bayonetta Game 1, because he was hovering over Zero Suit for quite a bit during the character select, so I was almost positive he's going to be selecting Zero Suit.
I probably just wanted to test that as Bayo. All right. And, you know, some things about that neutral B for ZSS. From what I'm hearing, a lot of people are using ZSS as a bit more of a zoner, more than she was before. But the electricity, the stun, universally seems to be lower for a lot of different characters. Corrin, Zero Suit. I wonder if that's just going to stick around, that chain.
I mean, it definitely should.
Mm. You think so?
Yes.
Oh. Why?
Just because it kind of lasted a long time in Smash 4.
Yeah, I was given a
you
long
had,
time.
You had all the time in the world to walk up, then walk away, make some toast, then go back and get your punish.
Yep. Oh, yeah. Lots of free kills for Zero Suit, for sure. Just down B them afterward. I'm looking at a fairly even game right now.
Yeah, we've seen 9S play a little bit more keep away in this set, or in this match, than he was in the Bayonetta, because the Bayonetta really had to approach. Mm. This one, PL's trying to almost space him out just the way 9S would.
That was some good stuff from PL. I like the options that he's taking. Almost getting him two different occasions.
We've seen the neutral B used a lot in recovery, especially like edgeguard positions.
Yeah. I see those tragic moments where Zero Suit just totally flubs it. Oh boy.
Wow, just like that. Trading Zare with the neutral B.
Huh, so it looks like you can hit the neutral B. But it doesn't look like a fair trade at all. Nice, that's a dead Piranha.
Yeah, that's why the stun should be reduced.
I can see that. I mean, it is. Oh, missing that that up tilt. Yeah, and that Piranha Plant Snare, very reminiscent of Ivysaur's. Sends it a bit of a different of a trajectory, but still pretty good as an ulti-hit move.
Gets the parry, but no follow-up or punish. Mm,
that dash attack has some nice range on it, too. Down throw.
Yeah, it looks like he can actually follow up his down throw with an up air.
That seems fair. Oh, man. I like what PL's doing. I really do. That neutral B seems to be a real workhorse. Good Nair.
Mm-hmm. That looks like a good move to cross up with.
Great move to cross up with. Good out of shield option. Yeah, I can see that being like really.
But does it combo into itself?
I don't think it does.
I think that's a requirement to be a good character. So.
Yeah, that's true. The Ike test. Ooh, okay. Trying to catch PL. All right.
Oh, and X is there, but it's not able to follow up.
But I like this adaptation from PL, however. I do enjoy that. He's using Zare to try to outrange Piranha Plant.
Mm-hmm. We're seeing PL play a bit more aggressive at this point. Mm. 9S has been able to kind of weave around the moves that PL's throwing out and then either punish with like Poison Cloud or the neutral B.
Oh, wow. Okay, that was good. Saving that jump. Good down B, too. Okay, getting a nice little bit of damage. Almost killing. Oh, God. How do you contest that up B?
Well, it looked like he had the right idea with the kickflip and then throwing out the hit of the kickflip to get the spike.
Well, it looks like the head is the most vulnerable. That seems to be the thing that you'd want to smash. Oh, yeah. Get out of that.
Using it as a smokescreen.
I like it. Woo. Very nice. Nair off stage? No.
Okay, free punish. Just getting a back throw and trying to set up, but a kickflip from PL will get him back on stage and take 9S's stock.
Okay. Nice little down air to just start this stock off with a bang. Okay. Paralyzer, not really getting shielded. Oh, man. And that neutral B really is good. It's a kill move. You can just cover so many different options. Very nice.
Mm-hmm. Good strings coming up from PL, keeping 9S into the air with a good amount of up airs, challenging with the nair, but doesn't find it.
Oh, that back air, though. Oh, man, and Zero-Suit really wants to take this one out.
Okay, so the Spike Ball actually has a good amount of projectile durability. Mm-hmm. It just ate that almost fully charged charge shot.
I do like this movement from 9S as well. He seems to enjoy like the range that this character gives him.
Oh,
that might be dead.
Did he DI that correctly? I feel like he could have lived.
He may have been able to. I'm really not sure. I mean, Zero-Suit.
There are options where, just about every character can use their jump to keep them alive and just stop the momentum from going into the blast zone. That definitely looked like one of them.
Yeah.
One of those opportune moments.
Yeah. It's not like Zero-Suit had that much rage on her. She's only 82.
Let's see. What is? Are we going into Omega Flat Zone? No, that's banned.
Oh, is it really?
Yes. You can't go to any of the stages that have no C access.
Oh.
So like the Game & Watch stages or that one Kirby stage that's on the Game Boy.
Oh, I see. That makes sense. Because you need to be able to use the entire mechanics of that.
Yeah.
Alright, so it looks like we're going to keep the same, Keep the same matchup.
Alright, I like it. Sticking out with the Plant Gang, committing to the Piranha.
Alright. Just going on a nice, even playing field here. Well, honestly, it's not as good for Zero-Suit, I don't think, if she loses those platforms.
That's right. PL was making good use of the triplats in the last stage, especially at the last stock. Saw attack on 80% easily just with sharking up airs and then converting and continuing the up air after up air. Oh, right there. Oh, here we go.
Of, okay, that was a good attempt at the cross up there, too. Nice.
Seems like PL's definitely adapted to this matchup.
Yeah.
Knows exactly what he needs to look for now.
It's weird because Zero-Suit can be very aggro, but can also outrange you in many different situations, like with that move, with Zare.
You can play keep away if she needs to.
Oh, yeah. Which has been working out for PL, because 9F is just kind of, mauling.
That dash attack has a weird hitbox. You saw the pot, actually go inside Zero-Suit, but there was no hitbox at the moment.
So I wonder if you're able to hit the... I don't even know what to call it. The Patooey. I'm just going to call it that. The Patooey. So if you hit it, does it still have active frames out? Are you still
vulnerable? The ball?
Yeah.
So okay. if you hit Piranha Plant while it's blowing air and keeping it in the air, when it falls, it still has a hitbox.
Even if you hit the ball itself?
That I'm not sure.
Okay. That was almost punish time.
Okay. Good nair to punish the whip grab.
Ooh. Yeah, both of these players whipping their aerials here. Just, basically getting back into the neutral here. Ooh, that down B was kind of risky, just a little bit.
Okay, we're starting to see 9S pull out a lot more shield. He knows that PL's been doing a lot of reverse charge shot, or turnaround charge shots. He's gotten a lot of damage on this first stock. You see back throw, set up the spike ball. Oh, good jump!
Good recovery. Okay. Doing a little bit of shield damage, but we know that Zero-Suit's not really known for that. I don't see enough approaching with Nair from PL.
I mean, he probably is afraid to do it because, up B is still an option.
Yo, let's go!
Let's see. You can still... Zero-Suit has an amazing anti-air with up smash. Up B out of shield is still a thing. And she does have good shield options, so.
Ooh,
there you go. There's a cross up back here to punish the grab.
That was really clean. Okay. Yeah, I'd like to see some more of the nair out of shield from 9S, just because of the way that the Zero-Suit Samus likes to land with aerials on shield, from what I've been seeing.
That's a good option, but I don't think you can get too much from the nair. And that's the biggest issue here. It's you need to get a bigger punish because you're playing catch-up.
Yeah, it's true. Especially since you're playing catch-up. But being able to get positional advantage, it's never hurt anybody.
Even right there, it's been looking like Piranha Plant's been able to convert off the down throw, but I can't tell if that's just PL not reacting in time. But right there, we see another charge shot into down B.
That's been a problem for 9S.
PL's getting, he's been making great use of this charge shot.
I agree. Oh, okay. Missing the Zera, but still kind of just going through the cloud and just jabbing him out. Now look where 9S is. Oh, that reverse shark shot again. Yeah, it looks like 9S on his final stock is really trying to be wary of that.
Oh, and he took his jump.
Oh, I do like that recovery.
Yeah, nice coverage. I'm calling it now. Dash attack from Piranha Plant, not a good tool.
Yeah?
No, it's just, with the animation, it looks like he has a bigger hitbox than he does, and he kind of like slides towards the end of his attack. Puts you in a horrible position.
I would like to see the end lag on it, and see just how safe it is, like on max.
I mean, even if it had like no end lag, the fact that you slide at the end when you have no hitbox, it's like, ooh, not a good tool. But that up throw
kills, okay. That should be a kill throw, honestly. Look at him. Okay. I mean, we're not breaking 100. Never mind. I cursed it. Yeah, we're breaking 100 now. We got a bit of a fight here. Oh. Can you grab ledge like that?
With the down B?
What I just saw.
With the extended neck?
Yeah.
I don't think so.
Ah, yeah. That down. That back air will take it.
Well, another L for our plant gang.
Oh.
Plant gang not looking good for our plant gang.
But I do like what I'm seeing from plant game.
Man, I need to. I just want like to see one amazing plant Piranha Plant player so I can use all my plant puns.
Do you play Piranha Plant?
No, I don't. But I have plant puns.
I would love to hear a plant pun.
You know what? We gotta earn those. We gotta earn those. Yeah, you don't get those for free.
Oh man.
You don't get Z puns for free.
I mean, I just throw them out like they're candy. Honestly, I have way too many to not make people cringe with. Oh, goodness. All right. But yeah, back to the old FGC talk. Do you